Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. I am Ruby. In this lesson, we're gonna learn the present tense in Korean. The present tense is used when you're talking about what you usually do, what you are doing now, or what you are going to do in the near future. There are many ways to express present tense though. In this lesson, we're gonna focus on the most common present tense endings, which are 아요, 어요, and 해요. First, let's practice how to pronounce these endings properly. Listen and repeat, please. 아요 아요 어요 어요 해요 해요 Excellent! Then, let's start learning the basic rules for the present tense. Rule number one. If the last vowel of the stem is a or o, add 아요. What does this mean? To understand this rule with ease, let's take the word 달다. 달다 is an adjective which means to be sweet. And 달다 is the dictionary form. In order to say this word in the present tense, you need to change the form of it. Then, how to change this word? Firstly, you drop the last syllable, which is 다. Because 다 is just attached there to make it the basic form. Now, since you dropped 다, you have 달 left, and this 달 is the stem of this adjective. Then look, what is the vowel of the stem? Yes, it is 아. So, according to the rule number one, you put 아요 at the end of the stem 달, like this. 달아요, 달아요. 달아요 is the present tense of 달다. Let's take a look at the sample sentence. 설탕은 달아요. 설탕은 달아요. Sugar is sweet. 설탕은 달아요. 높다. 높다 is an adjective which means to be tall. And 높다 is the dictionary form. Let's change the dictionary form into the present tense form. First, you drop the last syllable 다. Now, you have 높 left, which is the stem of this word. Then, you find the vowel of the stem. What is it? Yes, it is 오. So, according to the rule number one, you are gonna add 아요 to the 높. 높아요. 높아요. 높아요 is the present tense of 높다. Let's take a look at the sample sentence. 건물이 높아요. 건물이 높아요. The building is tall. 건물이 높아요. is a verb which means to go. Let's change the dictionary form into the present tense form. First, you delete 다. Now you have the stem which is 가. Then, what is the vowel of 가? Yes, it is 아. So, you are gonna add 아요 to 가. 가요. Is this right? No, Korean people do not say 가요 because there is a better way to say this one. If the stem does not have 받침, you don't need to say 아 because without 아, it is much easier to pronounce. 가요, 가요. 가요 is the present tense of 가다. Let's take a look at the sample sentence. 학교에 가요. 학교에 가요. I go to school. 학교에 가요. 사다. 사다 is a verb which means to buy or to get. And 사다 is the dictionary form. Let's change 사다 to the present tense form. First, you delete 다. Now, you have 사 left, which is the stem of this word. We're gonna find that the vowel of 사 is 아. So, according to the rule, you're gonna put 아요 at the end. 사아요. Now look, the stem 사 has no 받침. So in this case, you don't need 아 here as well. So, it becomes 사요. 사요 is the present tense form of 사다. Let's take a look at the sample sentence. 가방을 사요. 가방을 사요. I buy a bag. 가방을 사요. Rule number 2. If the last vowel of the stem is not 아 or 오, add 어요. Let's take the word 먹다. 먹다 is a verb which means to eat. And 먹다 is the dictionary form. Let's change this to the present tense form. First, you dropped 다. Now, you have 먹 left. And this 먹 is the stem. What is the vowel of 먹? It is 어, which is not 아 or 오. So, according to the rule number 2, you are gonna put 어요 at the end, like this. 먹어요, 먹어요. Let's take a look at the sample sentence. 아침을 먹어요. 아침을 먹어요. I eat breakfast. 아침을 먹어요. 울다. 울다 is a verb which means to cry. And 울다 is the dictionary form. In order to change 울다 into the present tense form, first, you're gonna remove 다. Now, you have 울, which is the stem. And you're gonna find that the vowel of the stem is u, which is not a or o. So you're gonna add 어요 at the end. Now we have 울어요. 울어요. Let's take a look at the sample sentence. 아기가 울어요. 아기가 울어요. A baby is crying. 아기가 울어요. Rule number 3. If a verb or an adjective ends with 하다, change 하다 into 해요. Let's take the word 좋아하다. 좋아하다 is a verb which means to like. As you can see, 좋아하다 ends with 하다. So, all you have to do is just change 하다 into 해요. 좋아해요. 좋아해요. Let's take a look at the sample sentence. 저는 커피를 좋아해요. 저는 커피를 좋아해요. I like coffee. 저는 커피를 좋아해요. 따라! Today's last word. Here we have 운동하다. 운동하다 is a verb which means to work out or to exercise. Since 운동하다 ends with 하다, you're gonna change 하다 into 해요. 운동해요. 운동해요. Let's take a look at the sample sentence. 저는 매일 운동해요. 저는 매일 운동해요. I work out every day. 저는 매일 운동해요. Good job! I am really proud of you. 오늘도 참 잘했습니다. 다음 에피소드에서는 과거 시제와 미래 시제를 공부할 거예요. 많이 기대해 주세요. 지금까지 루비였습니다. 좋은 하루 보내세요. 안녕!